to show you how to install Valvelink DTM for FieldView instruments onto your computer. To begin, start up your installation media. It comes on a CD, a flash drive, or a digital download. I will be installing the software from a flash drive. So I'm going to go ahead and start up the software. Okay, this is the first window that shows up. These are just the different types of Valvelink software that you can install, but today we're just going to focus on Valvelink DTM. So go ahead and check the box, and then click Next. Accept the terms of the license agreement by clicking Next. And then here you can change the destination folder of the program, but I'm going to leave it at its default. So click Next. And then to confirm the installation, click Finish. This will take a couple minutes, so I'm just going to bring up the first window that pops up when it's done installing. Okay, you do need a license to run Valvelink software, and that usually comes on a hardware key. So make sure that it's plugged in before hitting OK. I've got mine plugged in, and that's how I'll be licensing my software today. So click OK. Okay, here are the features that are associated with your hardware key. Go through the list and make sure everything looks okay. If it does, click Yes, and then click Next. Okay, now register your software. Type in your information. It pulled up most of mine for me, so I'm just going to register the software under Emerson. Click Next. Okay, that was done successfully, so we're going to click Finish to finish the license wizard. And here's the README information. You can pause the video and read that if you want, but I'm not going to. Click Next, and now go ahead and restart your computer. And when we'll come back, we'll install our FDT. Okay, Valvelink should have successfully installed onto your computer. Now we're going to install the FDT. I'm going to use Pactware from Vega.com. I'm going to click the Software tab, and then I'm just going to install the newest version of Pactware. And that's a pretty big download, so that'll take a couple minutes. But when it's done installing, open up the folder, and then we're going to unzip it. I'm just going to unzip it into the Downloads folder. I'm going to click OK, and then click Close. And now we're going to open the folder that was just created. I'm going to start the installation by clicking Windows Installer Pactware file. Okay, click Next to begin the setup wizard. Accept the terms of the license agreement. And here you can change the destination folder. I'm not going to. Click Next. And then click Install to install Pactware. Okay, click Finish. And Pactware should have successfully installed. Now we're going to start up the software. Okay, this is the main screen of Pactware. First, we're going to start by going up to View and then making sure Device Catalog is highlighted. Now we're going to go over to the right and click on the tab. These are the drivers that should have been installed when we installed Valvelink. Pactware should have found them all, but we're going to update the device catalog as a precaution, just to make sure. So click Yes. And now we're going to check it. And it doesn't look like anything changed, so that just means that Pactware found all of the drivers. So that's good. Now we're going to get the Heart Communication DTM driver that will allow us to use FieldView instruments. We're going to get those from CodeWright.biz. On the sidebar here, click Downloads, and then click Software. And that'll bring up the list of drivers. We want the Heart Communication DTM driver. You do need an account to download it from this website, but it's free, easy to do. So once you have that, go ahead and download the driver. I have my driver here already on the desktop. So I'm going to open that up and start the application. Okay, we're going to click Next to begin the setup wizard. And accept the terms of the license agreement. And then type in your user and organization information. Mine was pulled up for me. And then click Install to install the driver. Okay, Now that's completed. We're going to click Finish, and we're going to open back up Pactware. Okay, now you don't see the heart communication driver at the moment, so we're going to update the device catalog. Go back to the device catalog, and now you can see it there at the bottom. So that was installed correctly. So now we can go ahead and add devices. I'm going to go up here to Device and then Add Device. Going to highlight the heart communication and then click OK. And now it shows up under the device tag list. Now we're going to highlight that and then click Add Device to add our field view instrument. I have a DVC6200 plugged in, so I'm going to highlight that one to add. You just add whichever one you have plugged in. And now that was added, so we're going to connect. Okay, it was successfully connected, so now you can see the device type, the status, and everything, and you know it's connected when the symbol is green. So now we're going to go up to Device, and we're going to go to Additional Functions and ValveLink DTM. And this is how you access the DTM software, so you can communicate with your field view instrument. Okay, that is it for how to install and set up ValveLink DTM.